Hello TV fam! Welcome sa panibagong vlog. So for today's video nga, ang pag-uusapan natin is isa sa mga annual costs na nai-incur ng isang homeowner. So dito nga sa apartment namin, ang apartment namin is 2-bed, 2-bath, around 986 square feet. Meron kaming binabayaran na home insurance on a yearly basis. And so, last week, tinawagan natin yung insurance broker natin para malaman natin kung magkano ba yung cost ng renewal ng ating insurance. At ito na nga yung pag-uusap na yun.
Have you received your renew policy?
Maybe, but it could be with my wife. That's the reason why I was calling. Maybe you could provide information since you're in the system.
Oh, okay. I see. So, you said you received the email. It's from Lena?
Correct.
Oh, okay. Just one second.
Show insurance. Yeah, speaking. How can I help you?
Hi, my name is John. And I received a call, an email from Lena.
Yeah.
Regarding a notice for the renewal of our home insurance.
Okay, just a second, John. I will open you here.
Am I speaking with
John, right?
Yes, am I speaking with Lena?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha. Hi, Lena.
I'm good. How are you, John?
Good as well.
Perfect. So yeah, we received notice from insurance company that your payment is due.
Correct. Yes. Would you know how much is the amount for the insurance?
Just a second. Total amount $1,095.
And what was the amount that I previously paid last year's?
Last year was $973.
Ooh.
So very little increase.
Okay, but there was still an increase, right?
It will be every year. It will be, unfortunately.
How much was the increase again? 1,000, what's the new amount?
973 last year, okay. 1,095 this year.
Oh, wow, that's a 110 jump more or less. 120.
Yeah.
Is there a reason why... Because there was no claims regarding it, so I was wondering why was there quite a jump? On historically with Peace Hills, what we had is there were even a time where we didn't have an increase and we had to pay what we had paid before. But now it seems like there's nonstop increase on a yearly basis, and the increases are increasing as well. But we didn't have any, like, claims.
Yeah, but historically we didn't have that inflation. So insurance companies now, when they're replacing or rebuilding, they're paying different premiums than 5 years ago, for example. So they have to increase the premium. Plus, reinsurers that insure insurance companies, they are increasing their premium because they are insuring all the catastrophe in the world. Earthquake insurance went up significantly, specifically for Richmond. It's a lot of factors, and it will happen, at least for the next couple of years. This is what we see.
Yeah, but the $120 increase is significant. It's not like a $30 increase or a $40 increase. Is there, can you check the policy and make me understand as to what changed? What are the sections that increased, that contributed to the $120 increase for the policy?
I can compare premium for last year,
yes,
for the same coverages, but what contributes in it, I won't be able to see.
So yes, let's do that. That's exactly what I was looking at.
So last year, they were providing you 53,000 coverage for 493 base premium. This year, it's 56,000, personal property for 587. So base premium went up right there.
How much is the difference between for the base premium?
587 and 493. So almost $100.
Oh, yeah. And what that base amount, even if there's no claims or whatsoever, is that supposed to increase?
It's increasing because reinsurer increasing premium for insurance companies and because replacement cost of the items are higher. Like when you go to store to buy furniture two yes. years ago and now, it's two different premiums. So insurance company has to pay higher premiums as well when they're replacing your personal property. That's why they increase your price by that inflation factor that they're facing too.
Okay. Based on the insurers that you have, is there anyone that you could recommend that may help me retain my existing while having the same coverage and amounts?
Honestly, no, because the best, like the cheapest company in the area, they do not provide earthquake coverage. They could place you before with them, but nobody provides earthquake in Richmond, and you have it on your policy.
Which one, sorry? Which one was it?
Earthquake coverage.
Oh, I see.
That's close to not possible to get this coverage anymore in Richmond, so I would really stick to it if you already have it.
I lost her. So insurance to, renewal ng home insurance.
Hello?
Hello?
Sarah?
Hi. Can you please speak with Lena?
Oh, please wait.
Thank you.
Hello. Sorry, John. We got disconnected.
Yeah.
All the phones.
Yeah, then I got cut off. So, sorry. You were saying what was the coverage that no one is offering now from other providers?
Earthquake coverage.
Earthquake.
Yeah.
Ah. Okay, so nobody's...
This one is not possible, no.
Gotcha, and no one's covering that anymore. Ngayon, narinig nyo doon sa insurance broker na dito sa Richmond, particularly, maybe applicable din siya sa Vancouver in total, no? Medyo nagkakahirapan kumuha ng coverage for earthquake. Good thing na nga lang, no, na yung policy natin from the very, very beginning, sinama na natin yan. So, hindi siya basta-basta pwedeng tanggalin sa policy mo. Unless, personally, ikaw, as a homeowner, choice mo na tanggalin siya as part of your coverage. Now, magtataka siguro kayo, bakit nga ba nagkakahirapan na maisama tong gantong klaseng coverage sa home insurance? Ang sagot dyan ay makikita nyo sa susunod na clip.
So that ocean plate is being pushed towards North America. When it reaches North America, just offshore, it's actually stuck. Typically, that lock state continues for hundreds of years, somewhere between 250 and 850 years. The rocks along that fault zone will break, and the Juan de Fuca plate, that oceanic plate, will slip 10 or 20 or 30 meters. That would be the magnitude 9 earthquake. It extends from Vancouver Island all the way down to Northern California.
In 2011, Japan was hit with a magnitude 9 earthquake. It triggered a devastating tsunami.
Now, it makes a lot of sense. Kaya nga siguro nahihirapan ng kumuha dahil merong pending na fear na tinatawag about the big one. Lower mainland will be affected kung mangyayari man talaga ito. Kaya everyone is scared kung, you know, if that happens, paano na lang yung property nila? So, paano na lang yung magiging damage at makakover ba sila? So, yun yung naging, I think, big factor kung bakit mahirap kumuha ngayon ng insurance na nagko-cover ng earthquake. If meron man makikita, kapareho nung sinabi ng insurance broker, is medyo premium talaga yung babayaran nyo. Now, tuloy na natin yung vlog.
They excluded it last year, and now we really struggle placing people with companies because they are not providing this coverage.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's interesting. Okay. When is my policy due for renewal again? Like, when is the date? What's the exact date?
September 7 was renewal date.
Oh, we passed it.
Yeah, That's why they send the reminder notice.
Okay, gotcha, gotcha. Have you ever had experience with family insurance?
Unfortunately, no. We don't sell them, and I personally never purchased from them, so oh. I can't really say anything.
Gotcha, okay. So among the recommended, based on your what you've dealt with, what are the insurer names or policies that you've worked with a lot, apart from Peace Hills?
It depends on the area because of the restrictions.
For Richmond,
we are trying Intact, but they are very expensive. They do provide coverage for earthquake, but they're very expensive.
Okay, and then who else do you see that people are getting their policies from in Richmond?
That's it. Nobody else provides earthquake coverage at the moment.
Okay. But without taking into consideration the earthquake coverage, who do you see in the market? Like, who's the provider here in Richmond that people are getting?
Wawanisa Steel Provider, Aviva, Intact. They'll provide you with basic coverage, but not everybody provides additional coverages.
Okay. When I was with Peace Hills, the people residing in our house works for the government, do you get some sort of a rebate of some sort? Is there any benefits that is given to government employees?
I don't think so.
No, nothing?
Not that I heard of, no.
All right. Okay, so the total amount, again, is 1,095?
95.
1,095. Okay. Okay, I guess let's just go ahead and process this one.
Okay, how would you like to pay for it?
Via credit card? So yun na nga guys, nagbayad na ng home insurance. Ang home insurance namin dito sa unit namin for a 2-bed, 2-bath, 900 plus square foot unit is nasa $1,095 na. Can you just imagine when we started paying for home insurance way back in 2017, ang rate pa back then was, I think, $595. No? Same coverage. And then nagkaroon ng insurance crisis na tumaas yung mga premiums, tumaas yung mga deductibles. Tumaas siya ng, I think, 600 something, 690. And then it kept on increasing and increasing. I can't believe na ngayon, it's close to double na yung binabayaran ko for home insurance. Part yan ng cost of living. Unfortunately, you know, I guess hindi lang naman dito sa Canada. Pati din naman sa Philippines, ganito din, I believe, ang nangyayari. Pero in that span of time, no, I can't believe na talagang the price doubled, no, from the time that you started. Anyway, yun lang, at least na-share ko sa inyo. No? I tried to negotiate, I tried to check kung ano pa yung nandyan. Pero mapapansin mo naman kasi din sa kausap mo kung willing siya to spend time and get more information for you. Unfortunately, yung vibe na nakuha ko dun sa kausap natin is her time is precious. And she doesn't have the time to really provide or gather that information. Normally kasi yung mga broker na nakakausap ko, they will tell you, oh yeah, itong company to, they offer this. Although merong difference, they'll do the computation for you in their system. Kasi madali lang naman yun eh. Usually, they'll just create a tab doon sa system nila. So, halimbawa, kung ang provider is Wawanisa, Peace Hills, lahat lang yan, i-click nila. And then, copy-paste nila kung ano yung existing coverage mo. And then, makikita nila yung total amount. Unfortunately, dito sa kausap ko, hindi niya ginawa yun. Although, alam ko na pwede nilang gawin yun. Hindi ko na pinush, no? I think there's more things that I could spend in terms of my time rather than, you know, digging further na knowing na alam ko naman everything has gone up. So yun lang, at least gusto ko lang ma-share na nagtaasan yung presyo talaga. And I just can't believe na ito yung ganito kalaki na yung pinagbago ng insurance payment namin for a condo unit. No, condo unit. Can you just imagine kung magkano babayaran mo pagka bahay na siya? At saka siguro isang bagay din yan na kailangan ko itanong, since we're thinking of upgrading, paano yung insurance? Can we port yung existing insurance namin from this property to another one to cover? So, you know, few things na kailangan natin ma-validate and confirm, and something to add on our to-do list as we try to understand kung ano pa ba yung mga potential changes na gagawin natin. So, kung nakaabot kayo sa parte ng video na to, maraming maraming salamat. Kung hindi pa kayo subscriber ng ating channel, click nyo na yung subscribe button, yung notification bell, para lagi kayong updated sa mga latest upload natin. And then, comment down below kung meron kayong similar experience sa mga home insurance nyo, lalo na sa mga subscriber namin dito sa Vancouver. Or if not, no, kung nandito kayo sa Canada, share nyo din yung experience nyo regarding home insurance. Maraming salamat, hanggang sa muli. Magkita-kita tayo ulit sa susunod na vlog. Paalam. City of mine, how I love the city of mine. It never gets me down. City of mine.